Open the sequence viewer of a specific entry by clicking on its dot for the sequence type. Select the Restriction Analysis tab in the lower panel. Select Tools, Restriction Analysis, Add Enzyme Map. I will enable the option to select a single enzyme, and I will choose about one from the list. Press OK. The chosen enzyme is listed in the left below panel and the restriction sites are indicated. To map the restriction enzyme onto the sequence, double-click on the enzyme in the left panel or press the scissors button. The resulting fragments are listed in the right panel with the cut positions and the length of the fragments. The fragments are graphically plotted in the middle panel. This view can be switched on or off with this button. Let's do the same for a second enzyme. I choose THA1 and I uncheck Replace List option. The second enzyme is added to the left panel. I will as well map this enzyme onto the sequence. With this information, a virtual gel can be created. Select ABBA1 and choose Tools, Restriction Analysis, Add Selected Enzyme to Gel Window. Hover with the mouse over a band to see the molecular size. Do the same for the second enzyme, TAU1. Select Edit, Add Marker to display a molecular weight marker pattern on the gel. The position of a gel pattern can be changed with Edit, Move to the left. You can remove an enzyme from the list with this button. You can remove all enzymes from the map with the next button. Restriction enzymes can also be selected by using more general criteria. Click again on the binocular button and use the filter settings. Click on Change Filter Settings to fine-tune the cleavage. We can, for example, uncheck Blunt End and 3xN Protruding End and leave all other options checked. In the Length Recognition Site panel, check N equals 4 and uncheck all other options. Uncheck Include Restriction Enzymes Not Commercially Available and make sure all other options are checked in the Restriction Enzymes and Methylation panels. In the lower panel, I set minimal cuts to 1 and maximal cuts to 4. I check to replace the list and click OK. The enzymes that fulfill the specified criteria are shown in the left panel. Map an enzyme onto the sequence by double-clicking on it.